you look at Governor Christie, who was elected with great promise in 2009, and any major initiative that could have been pushed forward was thwarted by the fact that the legislature was the opposite party. So even though you spoke loudly in 2009 and elected Christie, there wasn't much we were going to get done when you return the same legislative leaders to power. So we switched one player in the whole game and nothing changed. Your taxes have gone up. The now the debate we have in New Jersey is which additional tax is going to go up. That's the debate we have. Not how are we going to change, fundamentally change the way we pay benefits and pensions, not change fundamentally the way we fund education, not change fundamentally the way the state offsets some of the local community costs when it comes to emergency responders, when it comes to teachers. Nope, not having any of those discussions. The discussions we have are, you know, the bridges are falling apart, so you need to pay more in taxes, even though we're already the highest tax state in the country. You know, Vincent Prieto had a statement the other day saying we are not going to even consider cutting the estate tax. Now, this is the tax that you pay when you inherit money. So someone dies, leaves you the family store or the house, and there's a tax on that amount. Now, there's money that's exempt from that. And, you know, so you're not going to pay a tax on every dollar because it's up to a certain amount. But the concept is, so I'm frustrated, and I know you are too, that you feel like you have the same exact conversation every single election and nothing changes. I don't know about you. My real estate taxes have gone up probably about 17 or 18%. You've probably had the same experience because they're, again, exceptions. So how does someone like Kim Guadagno, and just so we're clear, I don't even put her, I don't lump her in with the same administration that was working all these deals. Actually, I give her credit for being a relatively independent mind out there running around the state talking to small business owners. I've told you before, I spoke with her at the State House, I think it was last year, and we addressed a group of small independent business owners in New Jersey. And, you know, her message really resonated. And she's got her finger on the pulse when it comes to independent business. But beyond that, how do you deal with a legislature that does not want to have this conversation? How do you deal with a Steve Sweeney, a Vincent Prieto, that it's all about protecting what they've got?